We talk about nationalities and countries, right? Then we talk about there is and there are. And you are going to learn some new vocabulary. As, for example, camel, what are the new vocabulary that you remember about your field? That means petroleum, oil, and oil or gas.
Good morning.
Offshore. Good morning, Camel.
Offshore, onshore, walls, and oil field.
Very good, right? So you're going to look at the classroom, please. Look at the picture. Look at, please. All right, please, Bani Kanyabiri, could you describe, please, that picture using the is and there are? That's an oil field. Bani? Rodrigo Mamani, please.
An oil field.
There is an oil field, right? What else?
Pump jacks.
Yes. Okay. There are pump jacks. What else?
Pump jacks. Wells.
Good. There are sand wells.
Sure.
There is oil.
Offshore and offshore platform.
Right. Okay. So there is an offshore platform. Right. Very good. So when you use there is and there are, when you are going to describe places, right? And don't forget the new vocabulary, please, that you learned the last class: oil field, pump jacks, onshore, offshore, oil, offshore platform, wells, gas fields, oil fields, right? Those are the vocabulary that you learn this unit, right? Good. So I'm going to look up for your friends. Wait a minute, please. Brian? Brian, please, you need to write your last name. Brian, do you hear me? Brian, ¿me escuchas? Brian.
Sí, teacher, yes.
No olvides, por favor, anotar tu apellido también, right? Porque yes. No sé qué apellido voy a registrarte, all right? So, Brian, what's your last name? So you are going to write your last name. Okay, no olviden, por favor, ingresar con su nombre y apellido para que yo pueda registrarlos. All right? So, there are, right? So when you use it, when you are going to describe places. In this case, so you learn a lot of vocabulary, right? Not a lot of one, could be few ones, but you can use onshore, offshore, wells, oil, pump jacks, and others, right? Next, we are going to work with the audio. Do you remember that the last week we have a problem with the audio? So look at, please, for the test book, please, to page 5, and look at for exercise 1. In this unit 2, we talk about personal information. When you use personal information, when you are going to talk about, of course, or when you use the verb to be, right? So listen, please. Number 1, it's my job. Carl, it's a technician in a big oil company. What is he now? Listen and tick the correct boxes, right? The USA, inside, outside, right? You can have a lot of information there. You're going to write, please, or tick the correct one. Then look at, please, exercise 2. Read the questions and then listen again and answer them. Please, Liliana Kapcha, could you read the questions? Liliana Kapcha, could you read, please, the questions? Marco Antonio, please, could you read the questions? Evelyn Leconia, please, could you read the questions? Me parece que no están presentes, chicos. What did I think? Rubén Limachi, please, could you read the questions? Carlos Flores, please, could you read the questions? Richard Rodrigo, please, could you read the questions?
Teacher, why does he like his hop?
His photo. Very good. ¿Qué más?
Is he incident or outside today?
All right. Is he inside or outside today?
Yes.
¿Qué más, Rodrigo?
How many technicians are in his team?
Very good. How many technicians are in his team? Excellent.
Okay. How many men are outside with him?
Good. Are outside. Right. Very good.
Where are they from?
Excellent. Where are they from? Six.
How do you they speak to the control room?
Mm-hmm.
What nationalities are they in the company?
Very good. Excellent. Right. Now, please, you are going to listen the audio. And you are going to work with exercises, please, 1 and 2. Listen. Oh, sorry, that's a mistake. Wait a minute. Listen, please.
It's my job.
Hi, my name is Khalid. I am from the UAE, that's the United Arab Emirates. I am a technician with an oil company here. I like my job because every day is different. Today, I'm in a team of 5 technicians at a new plant. One man is inside in the control room and I'm outside with the other 3 men. One man is from the US and 2 are from India. We are from different countries, but we all speak English. We use radios to speak to the men in the control room. Most people in the company are Emirati, but there are many other nationalities too. American, British, Canadian, Egyptian, Indian, and many more. I like meeting foreign people and practicing my English.
Very good. Now listen again.
Unit 1. It's my job.
Hi, my name is Khalid. I am from the UAE, that's the United Arab Emirates. I am a technician with an oil company here. I like my job because every day is different. Today, I'm in a team of 5 technicians at a new plant. One man is inside in the control room and I'm outside with the other 3 men. One man is from the US and 2 are from India. We are from different countries, but we all speak English. We use radios to speak to the men in the control room. Most people in the company are Emirati, but there are many other nationalities too. American, British, Canadian, Egyptian, Indian, and many more. I like meeting foreign people and practicing my English.
Right. Unit 1. It's my job.
All right. So you have a minute, please try to answer. A minute. Okay, so please, Willy Carlos Ochoa, what about number one? Where is he now? Listen and tick the correct boxes, please. Willy Carlos Ochoa. Carlos Flores. What about exercise one? Marilyn Choque. Jesús Leonardo. Maike. No, nobody. A volunteer. Los estoy registrando como que no están. All right. A volunteer.
Richard Rodrigo.
Please, Richard Rodrigo.
Why does he like his cup?
About number one, Richard. What are the places? You listen, for example, outside, afuera, right? Outside. Then, United Arab Emirates and plant, all right? And Richard, what about the first one? Why does he like his job?
He's technician.
Very good. And why does he like his job? Because every day is different, right? He has different activities every day, right? Nancy Wanka, is he inside or outside today? Thank you, Richard. Nancy Wanka. Giovanna Lucana.
He's inside, teacher. Inside.
Okay, he's outside. Because don't forget that he's an engineer, so he works inside. Very good, Giovanna. Please, Rolly Carlos Kenta. How many technicians are in his team? How many technicians are in his team? Rolly Carlos Kenayata, sorry.
Licenciada, es Roy Kenayata.
Roy Carlos Kenayata, right?
Sí.
Okay.
Yes.
Good. How many technicians are in his team?
Control.
¿Cuántos? Five. Five. How many men are outside with him? Three. All right? Three. Brian, what's your last name? Brian, ¿cuál es tu apellido? Brian. Brian. Brian, please, what's
your name?
¿Cuál es tu apellido?
Pérez Pavón.
Ah, ok.
Estaba con mi cuenta institucional y, teacher, ahí está todo mi nombre. No sé si me aparece.
Aquí no genera, te cuento, solamente Brian. Entonces, por favor, les solicito que todos ustedes al ingresar, he hecho una excepción hoy porque es el probablemente no entraste en la anterior clase, yo ya había explicado que yo requiero que todos ustedes ingresen con su nombre y su apellido para que los vaya registrando, porque no llamo lista, ¿verdad? Los voy registrando justamente para cuando ustedes participan o no. El caso que ustedes a la tercera, segunda vez no participen, yo sí los elimino, chicos, porque es una pérdida de tiempo, ¿no es cierto? Estoy siguiendo los recuadros que veo en la pantalla para que todos ustedes tengan la oportunidad de participar. Muchos de ustedes probablemente no lo van a hacer porque no nos quedan los ejercicios suficientes como para que lo hagan. Si ustedes tienen algún problema con su micrófono, entonces pueden utilizar el chat. Pero si ustedes no se comunican durante la clase conmigo ni una vez, entonces yo registro como si no estuviesen presentes, ¿no es cierto? Y si ustedes no responden a la cuarta vez, entonces yo voy eliminando, porque así me permite crear realmente un grupo que sí está trabajando en la clase con su material y está dispuesto a intentar escuchar y resolver los problemas. Right? Entonces, please pay attention. Si ustedes tienen alguna dificultad, nuevamente lo aclaro, utilicen el chat, all right? So you can use the chat and I can too read, okay? Marilyn Choquehuanca, please. Where are they from? Where are they from?
I am.
All right. One is from. One is from the USA, and two are from India. All right. Jesús Leonardo, please, how do they speak to the control room? How do they speak to the control room? Oh, Jesús Leonardo. How do they speak to the control room? They use radios. Si ustedes no comprendieron y requieren escuchar nuevamente al audio, solicítenlo. All right? English teacher. Ah, all right. Yes. Okay, Carmen. So we are going to listen twice or three times. All right? Good. Finally, please. Ramos Baltazar. Right? I can't read your name, but I'm going to look at. Please, what nationalities are there in the company? Control room, okay. They use radios, oh, good. In the control room, that's a possibility. Very good, right. So please, Ramos Baltazar. Daniela. What nationalities are there in the company? American and Indian, very good, excellent, right? Emirati, American.
Egyptian.
Good, excellent, Carmel. Egyptians, British, Canadian, Indian, and many more, right? Good. So you have another homework, right? The last class we talk about definitive and indefinitive articles. Do you remember the rules? Could be someone asked to work with us and explain them. Do you remember? What about a, an, and singular ones? No? All right, so you are going to remember, right? So look at the picture, please. Okay, so please don't forget that in this unit we talk about countries and nationalities. Then we work with there is and there are when you are going to describe, right? And finally, the last class, we talk about the definitive articles. We have a, an, and the. All the things that you can count is singular. ¿Recuerdan? Todo lo que nosotros podemos contar es singular, right? Countable nouns. All of the things that we can count, so it's uncountable ones, right? Uncountable ones. Look at it. So we have uncountable nouns, all the things that you can count with oil or water, for example. Countable ones, all the things that you can count, for example, a wheel, right? If you're going to find a word that ends in a vowel, you are going to add A, E, I, O, U, right? For example, we have here a wheel, that we don't have any problem. Wells, if you are going to change to plural. An apple or apple, so we need a. Why? Because we have a next to, ¿no? Cuando tengo choque de vocales, debo emplear an, right? A city, a scarf, a tomato, right? So just a. But if you're going to find a vowel like an engineer, for example, an engineer. Why? Because I have E, porque tengo una E, right? An engineer. So I'm going to use that. No, entonces no olviden las reglas. Tengo dos grupos de nombres comunes, los contables y los incontables. Los contables, como su nombre indica, los puedo contar, right? Y está dividido en dos partes, singular y plural. Cuando voy a expresar singular, debo usar los artículos indefinidos a, or, an. An, cuando tengo choque de vocal, como es el caso de apple, an apple. Engineer, an engineer. Actor, an actor. Right? Cuando no tengo choque de vocales, voy a emplear a. Right? Just that. Cuando voy a transformar estos nombres comunes a plural, right, puedo emplear una S, una ES, una IEDS o una B corta ES. Cuando los transformo al plural, los artículos desaparecen, right? Por ejemplo, si encuentro un nombre que termina en una consonante, en cualquier consonante generalmente lleva una S. ¿No? A wheel, wheels. An apple, apples. S. Cuando encuentro un nombre que termina en Y, esa Y se transforma en una I latina ES. A city, cities. A country, countries. Right? Cuando encuentro un nombre que termina en F, esa F se convierte en una B corta. Right? A scarf, a scarves. Scarf significa bufanda, right? A scarf, a scarves. B-E-S. Todos los nombres que terminan en O, X, C-H, E, S-H o S-S deben llevar E-S. right? A tomato, tomatoes. A watch, watches. Watch means reloj, all right? We have the irregular nouns too. Tenemos los nombres irregulares. Estos nombres irregulares no corresponden a ninguna de las reglas mencionadas. Plural es diferente, right? A man, men. A woman, women. A person, people. A child, children. A mouse, mice. Right? So they are irregular. Por otra parte, tenemos a los incontables. Como indicábamos la anterior clase, los incontables no se pueden contar. Por lo tanto, son singulares. Si yo utilizo un contenedor, decíamos la anterior semana, sí, podemos contar. Right? A glass of water. A balloon of oil. Or things like that. So, it's possible. Right? So, we are going to work. Sorry. We are going to work with a, an. All right? And when you use the, cuando utilizo the. You know? That's your homework. Era su tarea. Cuando empleo the. When we are going to talk about singular and plural, right? S-E-S-I-E-S-B-E-S, when you are going to talk about plural. So when you use the, do you remember? ¿Alguien sabe? ¿Cuándo?
Cuando ya está definido.
In the definition.
Muy bien. Muy bien. Excelente. Cuando es algo que ya conozco, cuando es algo específico, right? Very good. For example, if I talk about a whale, so if it's something you know, you say the whale, right? So look at please this one. No olviden que todo el material que se utiliza está en Classroom y que ustedes pueden revisarlo las veces que ustedes quieran y justamente preguntar cuando tengamos estas sesiones en línea, ¿no? So look at please the, right? The is a definitive article used to talk about something specific. I told you, a whale, but it's something that I know. So you say the well. The town where Julie lives, it's very big. Could be Skoroiko. We don't know. Something that it's specific. What book is Julie reading? She's reading the book Tom gave her. A specific, all right? The is also used to refer to the river, seas, oceans, for example, the Mississippi River, the Mediterranean Sea, the Atlantic Ocean, and of course, when you talk about nationalities too, the British, the Americans, the Japanese, the Chinese. But it's something specific. Could be you say, you are going to work with, definitive and indefinitive ones, right? And we are going to review the homework, right? So look at please for the homework. Look at the Oxon Oil, please, technical department staff. Please don't forget that you are going to enter. Vamos a perder enseguida el enlace, all right? So please enter again. That's our second one. So look at please number one. Oxon Oil is a small company. So it's a, an, or the. What do you think?
The.
Very good, Kame. A small oil company. Look at number two. John is manager. No. And we don't have any vowel, right? Good. What about number three? You know that we talk about John. Ustedes ya saben. En el segundo ejemplo estamos, nos referimos a John, right? John is a manager in the company. So look at number three. John is manager of technical department. He's from UK. What do you think?
The volunteer. The manager of technical department.
Right. John is a manager for the manager.
Manager. The manager.
The. Muy bien. ¿Por qué es the y no es a?
Estamos definiendo, digamos, es el director, ¿no?
Es the, porque en el segundo ejemplo ya me referí a él, a su profesión, como algo que no conozco, ¿no es cierto? Indefinitive one, right? John is a manager in the company. And I know that. So I say Joe is the, right? It's the manager of the technical department. He's from, right? The United Kingdom. That's the possibility. All right? Very good, Cami. Look at, please, the next one. Four. Pierre is technician in department. He's from France. What do you think?
A technician in that department. He is France. No vamos a poner nada.
Excellent, right? So we don't need, right? So you say, Pierre is a technician in the department, because we talk about the department. He is from France, right? And finally, please, five, a volunteer. Greg is American technician.
Greg is American technician.
Right. Greg is an American technician. Why? Because you are going to find a vowel. Right? So don't forget the rules, please. Right? Don't forget the rules. I look at with you. So we have here an, right? That's the best one for you. Countable nouns are uncountable ones. Singular with an. Be careful with the vowels. Plural, S, E, S, I, E, S, and B, E, S, right? If you're going to talk about uncountable nouns, so you know that it's something that you can't count and you can use the containers. They are singular. Lo que no se puede contar es singular. Oil, yes. Water, yes. Right? And here you work with the, right? There's a definitive article, and you're going to use to talk about something specific. So you know, what do you, a town. So, but you say the town where Julie lives, it's very big, right? So be careful, because you can use the with rivers, seas, oceans, and when you talk about nationality, right? But be careful with a singular and plural, right? You can count pump jacks.
Yes.
Yes, you can count. You can count whales.
Yes, I can.
Right. What about oil?
I can't.
Right. You can't, because it's uncountable. Right. So look at, please, number one. We are going to work with the alphabet now, because you are going to spell the words. For example, onshore. How do you spell onshore? How do you spell onshore? O-N?
Yes.
O-N-S-H. O.
E.
R.
R.
E. Right. Very good. Now listen, please. Look at exercise one with a pronunciation. Listen and repeat, please. I know that's impossible that you are going to repeat, because there are a lot of loud, right? But try to practice in your house, right? Muy difícil que ustedes puedan pronunciar en grupo porque se genera mucho eco, pero háganlo, right? So you don't have, you doesn't work with your microphones, and practice, right? Listen, please.
Pronunciation. 1. A. H. J. K. 2. B. C. D. E. G. P. T. V. 3. F. L. M. N. S. X. Z. 4. I. Y. 5. O. 6. R. 7. U. Q. W.
Listen again.
Unit 1. Pronunciation. 1. A. H. J. K. 2. B. C. D. E. G. P. T. V. 3. F. L. M. N. S. X. Z. 4. I. Y. 5. O. 6. R. 7. U. Q. W. Unit 1.
Great. Look at, please, the book. Look at the page, please. 5. Exercise 2. Right. So you have here some vowels, right? A. E. I. O, U, all right? So, listen again and try to remember. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, Jake, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, B, double B or W. You can have both options, double B or W. X, Y, Z or Z. Look at here. Z, Z. British pronunciation, American pronunciation. All right? So, and we have here two questions. How do you spell your first name? My first name, yes, Evelyn. E-V-E-L-Y-N, Evelyn. How do you spell your family name? My family name is Molina, M-O-L-I-N-A, right? How do you spell well, W-B-E-O-W-L, right? Well, so when you don't understand or you don't know how to write, so you can use those expressions, please, right? How do you spell pump jacks? How do you spell onshore? How do you spell offshore, right? Could you spell oil, please? So we have different ways to ask them, right? So please, Ramiro, how do you spell pump jacks?
Repeat.
How do you spell pump jacks? How do you spell pump jacks?
Pump jacks.
Pump jacks. How do you spell pump jacks? All right, there, right? Pump jacks. That's pump. I guess okay. Okay. How do you spell Ramiro? Pump jacks. Puedes ver el chat, escribí la palabra. Pump, pump jacks.
G.
P-U-M.
No, P-P, P-U, P-U-M, P-H-A-C-Q is.
Very good, right. P-U-M-P-J-K-A-C-K-S. Right, very good. Edwin Duran, could you spell, please, oil?
O-O. E L.
Okay. O I L. Good. O I L. Right. please, Giovanna Lucana, please, could you spell offshore?
O double F is H O R E. Offshore.
E. Very good. Right. Which one is this? Which vowel is it? ¿Qué vocal es? A. Very good. This one?
E.
E.
Right. This one?
I.
I.
What about this one?
Oh.
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 Hmm?
Oh.
And this one?
You.
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 You. You. Very good. Excellent. Right? Voy a dejar los cinco minutos trabajando en grupos de a cinco, justamente recordando. Recordando el alfabeto, right? If you are five, for example, Camel, Luna, Jesús Leonardo, Edwin Durán, and Carlos Flores. So could be Camel start and say, A, Luna, B, Jesús Leonardo, C, Edwin, D, Carlos Flores, right? E, right? So try to practice, recuerden, right? Because then we are going to work with tools and we are going to need to spell the names of the tools, all right? So please accept the invitation, all right? Accept the invitation. Listen.
¿Entiendes?
Apellido es last name. Ah, ya, ya.
Ajá, sí.
Ah. ¿Practicamos con nuestros nombres y después con alguna palabrita del nuevo vocabulario que nos ha enseñado?
Sí, ¿no? Sí, sería mejor.
empieces, compañero. Camel.
Vale, vale, hermano.
A quien sea, preguntarle. Y practicaremos.
O sea, a ver, compañero, ¿cómo dices? O sea, vamos a deletrear el apellido, ¿verdad?
O lo que te pregunte.
Sí, sí, empezaremos así nomás, para sí. practicar.
Sí, por favor, es que tampoco entiendo mucho.
Ya empezaremos, Ricardo, ¿no? Rodrigo, ¿dónde se fue?
Aquí estoy.
How do you spell that, your name?
R-I-C-H-I-R-D.
Super. Preguntamos, pues, practicaremos, pues, hermano.
Yo te pregunto, how you spell, how do you spell next name? Así dijiste, ¿eh?
¿A qué te refieres en esto?
El apellido, ¿cómo dijiste, Slato?
Ah, last name.
Ah, last name, ya.
Ah, ya.
How do you spell last name?
A-L-T-E-R-E-M-S-I. ¿Quién más está? Creo que están durmiendo.
Pregúntale, ¿no? A mí.
Evelyn le coña.
Yo te pregunto, Evelyn. How do you spell your fish last name? Creo que
Disney, primer nombre, ¿no?
Uh-huh.
Ah, ya, yeah, Evelyn.
Mi apellido.
Primer nombre, dijo.
Primer nombre, perdón.
Disney.
O. S. A. I. A. Sería mi
good, good, good. Keep going. Super, super. Así practicamos poco.
Pues. Ahora pregúntele a Zubén. Zubén, sí,
pregúntenme a mí.
Ah, Rubén, how do you spell your last name?
L I M A C H E I.
Good, good, thank you.
¿Yo pregunto a alguien?
Pregunte, hermano. Pregunte.
Ahora podemos hacer por apellidos también, no sé.
Sí, sí.
¿Quién es 85? Luna.
Yo ya le pregunté a Evelyn.
Ah, estás aquí, pensaba que no estás aquí, perdón.
A ti también te preguntaré a una persona.
Ok.
How do you spell Phil's name?
W-I-R-I-A.
Wala. Uh-huh. Yes, very good. Y con apellido, ¿cómo era? Next name, ¿cómo has dicho, hermano?
Last name.
How do you spell?
Could you spell, please, oil field? Oil field. Look at the chat. Could you spell, please, oil field?
No está en el chat.
Sure. I'll write there. Y bueno, puedo verlo para de mí para todos. I'm going to write again. Oil field. All right. Can you see?
Yes.
Ahora sí.
All right. Okay. Sorry. Please, Evelyn, oil field. Evelyn.
Yes, teacher.
Oil field.
Oh.
Oh.
Oh. I. L. F. I. E. D.
E. L. D. Very good, Evelyn. Lisette, Sabrina, please. What about onshore fields? Lisette, Sabrina, Cáceres, I guess. Could you spell onshore fields?
¿Sí, me escucha?
Yes.
Okay. O M S H O R E F I L D S.
Right. F. Very good. Right. Please. Carmen Estaca, please, could you spell gas field?
Camel o Carmen?
Carmen Estaca, please.
Oh, sorry.
Yes. G A S L F
I
E L D S.
Very good. Right. Miguel Torres, please spell a storeroom. Oh, okay, I know that you have problems, right? S-T-O-R-E-R-W-O-M. Right. Don't forget, please, the spelling. Then we are going to practice when I talk about the tools and hardware, right? So now look at, please, the next exercise. Look at, please, the next exercise. That it's on page, please, 6. Number and talk. So you have there the store. The store or the storeroom or the stock room. What's the meaning? Do you know? What's the meaning of a store or a storeroom? British, English, store. And storeroom or a stock room, that's American English. What's the meaning in Spanish?
Store is storia in Spanish or no?
Okay, no, es un depósito o almacén, donde ustedes guardan las herramientas. Yes, that's it, right? Then we are going to talk. The building or room where tools and materials are stored, right? Es esa habitación, ese depósito donde ustedes guardan las herramientas y los materiales requeridos, all right? That's a store room or a stock room. So you can use British English or American one, right? And in this section, we are going to remember the numbers, right? We are going to remember the numbers. So please don't forget, you work with countries and nationalities. You use there is and there are, right? You talk about singular and plural nouns, countable and uncountable ones. And you remember, recordar, remember the numbers, right? And I'm going to show you a picture, right? So look at, please. Okay, so we have here numbers from 1 to 100, right? So look at, please, the base. This is the base, right? Sorry. Right. So the first one is zero. If you talk about telephone numbers, it's possible that you use O. All right? O. Right? Los números también son muy importantes para ustedes porque les permite dar información sobre el número de las piezas que ustedes requieren. Right? So don't forget to use them. So the first one is zero. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. And here you have 20. 20 means British English, right? 20. 20, American English. Para el inglés americano, esta T, se convierte en muda, right? Para el británico, voy a pronunciar tal cual. 20, 30, 40. Para el inglés americano, esta T se convierte en muda, right? 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, and 40, or 40, 41, 42, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49. A partir del 50, solo tengo una opción de pronunciación, right? Tal cual se escribe. 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, and 100 or 1,000 that you have here, right? Entonces, para el 30, perdón, para el 20, 30, 40, tengo dos formas de pronunciación, la americana y la británica. La británica tal cual se escribe, 20, 30, 40, right? La americana, en la cual la T se convierte en muda, 20, 30, 40. Es decisión personal si ustedes quieren emplear la americana o la británica, right? When you're going to talk about, for example, I don't know, but I'm going to write here, it could be 100, right? So, or 1,000, you say 456, right? Or you say 8,712. All right, which number is this? Which number is this? ¿Qué número es ese?
568.
Very good. 568. Which number is this?
12.
12. This one is?
3.
3. This one is? 13. This one is? 30. 30. Very good, right? But be careful, please, with that pronunciation, right? So, when you're going to pronounce this TH, so you're going to pronounce correctly. Look at my mouth. La lengua entre los dientes. All right? 3, 13, 30, 30, right? ¿Por qué? Porque si yo pronuncio tri, ¿qué significa? ¿Ustedes saben qué significa?
Árbol.
Arvalo.
Árbol. Árbol, y bien, significa árbol. Entonces la pronunciación es muy importante. Yo sé que uno de los objetivos de ustedes no es comunicarse, ¿no? Pero cuando ustedes ya estén trabajando aquí unos años, requieren comunicarse con otras personas, right? So that's important to remember, right? La lengua entre los dientes, es como si yo estuviese soplando, right? 13, 30, right? So look at and be careful, right? Good. So we are going to practice with the numbers again. Which number is this? Which number is this?
6,702.
Right. 6,702. Right. This one is
104.
Good, very good. 104. This one is
568.
Very good. And if you talk about telephone numbers, for example, I embed a number, okay? That's a telephone number. Los números de teléfono no los puedo leer de a pares, or 100 or 1,000. Los números de teléfono siempre los voy a leer uno por uno, right? You can use double. Puedo usar también como las letras double. For example, I said here, 7, 0, or 0, right? Para los números de teléfono, ustedes pueden usar 0 or 0 como una expresión. Cualquiera de los dos es correcta. All right? So, 7-0-8-9-1-3-3-8. Solo en los casos de números de teléfono. Then, you are going to read it like this one. Which number is it? 678, right? 678, right? What about this one?
102,
right? What about this one?
33
or 33, right? Number talk from 1 to 199. 1, count from 1 to 25 around the class, right? Could be Angela Tambo is going to count from 1 to 25. Angela, ¿puedes contar del 1 al 25?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12,
13,
13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23.
All right. Very good. Please, Esther, what's your last name? Esther, ¿cuál es tu apellido? What's your last name? Esther.
Teacher, una consulta. ¿Cómo se pronuncia 90? Ninety.
90. 90. 90. No olviden que a partir del 50, ustedes simplemente utilizan una única pronunciación. 50, 60, 70, 80, 90. Right. Esther, ¿cuál es tu apellido?
Mm,
Esther. Okay. Right. So please, Marisol Quequesana, could you count in 10, please? From 10 to 100. De 10 en 10, por favor, hasta el 100. Marisol.
It's okay, teacher. 10, 20,
30, 40,
60, 40,
30,
40, 40, 40, 40, 50,
50, 60,
70,
70,
80,
80,
90,
100. Very good. All right. So don't forget 10, 20 or 20, 30 or 30, 40 or 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100. All right? So that is the way. Look at please exercise 3. Study the information and say the numbers. How to say numbers? Telephone and references numbers. 01238. Don't forget. Or you can use 0. It's possible, right? 00 or 0 for telephone numbers. Solo para teléfonos, chicos. So that's possible to use both, right? My cell phone number is 7007404. So both is correct, right? If you talk about quantities, of course you are going to use like this way. 13, 30, 33 or 33. 100 or 100, 101. That's another kind, ¿no? Es posible también utilizar los números empleando and. 102, 104, 124. It's possible. Es posible. Pero no se los aconsejo, right? Because you're going to use all the time and. And it's not a good idea. So you can use directly. 2,174. 145. You know that's possible, pero saben que es posible. All right? So look at please exercise 4. Say these numbers, reference and phone numbers and quantities, right? What about picture A, Ronald? Ronald, Israel, please, could you read it?
Eight. 7, 9, 7, 8, 4, 1.
Very good. Right. Good. Look at please B, Willy Carlos Ochoa.
Seven, five, eight. 5, 6, 5, 6, 8.
Okay, right, but sorry, that it's B, right? Made in China, model number 4920, right? Or you can say here, that's not a telephone number, so 4920, right? Giovanna Lucana, please, what about C?
403.
Okay, 403. Right. Very good. Right. So, please, D, a volunteer.
Aquí dicen.
Please.
Liliana. 0, 0, 7, 5, 2, 8. 9, five, six, two, three, one.
Very good. All right. Excellent. Please, Edwin Duran, what about E? Just the. KPH, right? Or look at F, a volunteer, please, Nancy. Kilometers per hour, right? That it's KPH, right, Nancy? F? Nancy Wanka? 49 centimeters, right? 49 centimeters. Roger Gonzalo, please. A or G, sorry. Diego Rojas, G. Diego Rojas. Please. G.
La pregunta, perdón.
Yes. Read, please, G. Picture G. Lee la figura G, el número que tienes en la figura. Fifteen.
No estoy compartiendo pantalla.
No, no estoy compartiendo pantalla. Pero ustedes tienen el material, ¿verdad? Marcos Calle, please. What about H? Could you read the number of the bill? ¿Puedes leer el número del billete? A volunteer, please. A volunteer. Please, Carlos Flores or Rodrigo, I don't know. Carlos, please.
Teacher, $50.
Yes. Right, $50. Very good, $50. Excellent. Look at please number one, listening to the conversation. Listen to four conversations and number the pictures, please. Listen conversation one and two, please. You're going to listen four and number the pictures, right? Could be A, it's three, right? Tal vez la figura A corresponde a la conversación uno. Entonces ustedes van a notar los números, right? En el ejercicio 2, you are going to listen again and complete the information, right? The store is in building, in room. The technicians need bolts. Bolts means, do you know what bolts means? Tornillos, all right? The part number is, el número de pieza es, all right? His employee number is, número de empleado, yes. And the store phone number, yes. Right? So listen, please, and you are going to complete the information. Please. I think that's not okay. Wait a minute.
Unit 1, Listening. Conversation 1.
Excuse me.
Yes?
Where's the store?
I'm not sure. I think it's over there in Building 2.
Okay, thanks.
Conversation 2.
Excuse me.
Hi.
Where's the store?
It's over there, room 103.
Thanks.
Conversation 3.
Can I help you?
Yeah, I need 16 of these bolts.
Sorry?
16 of these bolts.
Do you know the part number?
PV3764.
Could you say that again, please?
PV3764.
Is that PV or BV?
PV3764.
Okay, I need your employee number.
That's 0725.
0725. Okay.
Conversation 4.
There aren't any here, but I can get some from the main store. Can you call me in half an hour?
Sure. What's the number?
784-522.
784-552?
No. 522.
784-522. Okay. I'll call you later.
Right.
Listen again.
Unit 1. Listening. Conversation 1.
Excuse me.
Yes?
Where is the store?
I'm not sure. I think it's over there in Building 2.
Okay. Thanks.
Conversation 2.
Says one.
Excuse me.
Hi.
Where's the store?
It's over there, room 103.
Thanks.
Conversation 3.
Can I help you?
Yeah, I need 16 of these bolts.
Sorry?
16 of these bolts.
Do you know the part number?
PV3764.
Could you say that again, please?
PV3764.
Is that PV or BV?
PV3764.
Okay, I need your employee number.
That's 0725.
0725. Okay.
Conversation 4.
There aren't any here, but I can get some from the main store. Can you call me in half an hour?
Sure. What's the number?
784-522.
784-522?
No. 522.
784-522. Okay. I'll call you later.
Right.
Right. That's a Mexican people. Great. All right. So please, I don't know, be here. Miguel Torres, please. What about teacher A? Which conversation is it? 1, 2, 3, or 4? Ángela Tambo. Marilyn Choquehuanca. Oh, 2. Oh, thank you. Right, you say Ivan Gomez, 3. Right. Very good. A is conversation 3. Excellent. Right. Please, Kamel, what about B? Which conversation is it?
Good.
One, two, three, or four?
One.
Four. Four. Very good, Luna. It's four. Thank you, Kamel. So it's conversation four. Edwin Duran, please, again. What about C?
C?
It's conversation?
Conversation one.
Excellent. It's conversation one. Right. Ronald Israel, please, what about D? It's conversation? Ronald? Okay, four. Right. But C is one, right? And D is conversation two, right? Is conversation two. Look at, please, exercise two. And what about number one? Marcos Calle, number one. The store is in building. Jorge Cristian.
Number two, teacher.
Okay, the store is in building two, right? In room?
13.
103. Right, very good, yes. 103, right? 103. Right? Look at, please, number two. Look at number two, please. Bani Kanyaviri, the technician's needs.
No, teacher, esa no la entendí muy bien. Sí, la
60.
Very good. 16. Very good, 16. Liliana, excellent, right? 16, right. The part number, el número de pieza, the part number, Roy Carlos. The part number is... Okay, right, good. So you can use PB, okay? PB 374, all right, 3764, 3764, right? PB 3764, that's the part number. Evelyn, please, his employee number is?
Oh, 0725.
Yes, very good. 0725, right? Zero, very good, Jorge Cristian, right? Excellent. 0725. And the store phone number is Ronald Israel, please. The store phone number is good, very good. Very good, Ivan, right? So you can say 784522, right? Not two, because you listen in the conversation, this one, it's two, right? Good. So don't forget that the part number is important that you are going to remember in your vocabulary, right? Número de piezas. So don't forget it, right? PN, if you are going to find contracted way, PN. Se abrevia de esa forma también, all right? PN, right? Número de pieza, part number. Or P/and, right? Cuando ustedes vean los repuestos, las herramientas, so you can use PN or P/N, right? What does it mean? ¿Qué significa?
Número de piezas.
Muy bien. In English?
In part English? Number.
Excellent. Part number. Ya saben que los números de pieza son una combinación de números y letras. Right? So please don't forget it. Practice. Por favor, practiquen en casa. The alphabet, numbers. Aunque parezca información que no la requieren, es muy importante. All right, so practice at home, listen the audios, practice the pronunciation and so on, right? So look at please the next one, look at please the next page, look at please. Now I'm going to share with you the material because I need that you can see some objects, right? So look at please to page 7, right? Useful phrases, getting repetition. Could you say that again, please? Sorry, what's that again? So you are going to spell it. For example, spanner, right? S-P-A-N-N-E-R, right? Or wrench, right? You say W-B-R-E-N-C-H, right? So you have here British English and American English. So you have the both options at the beginning. Right? But now please look at the vocabulary, right? Look at the vocabulary. Ah, sorry. Right? So look at please the pictures. This one is a screwdriver. What's in Spanish a screwdriver? Tools and hardware, right? What's an a screwdriver? What's this in español? A screwdriver. What does it mean?
Destornillador.
Destornillador. Right? So look at please B. What are these? Screws.
Tornillo.
Tornillo.
Tornillo. Tornillo.
Right. Right. What about C? Spanner. A spanner.
Yeah.
In Spanish. Llave. Right. Yeah. What about D? What does it mean? Tuercas, right? You can use that. What about wrench? What does it mean?
Llave.
Llave inglesa, right? Maybe that is the little difference with a spanner. What about a bolt?
Tornillo.
Pernos, right? Mm. Tornillos. What are the difference between them? ¿Cuál es la diferencia?
La forma.
Screws and bolts. El ensamblaje, right? So they are different, but means the same, right? Tornillos, pernos. Look at please the next one. An electric drill. What does it mean? Taladro eléctrico.
Eléctrico.
Right. What about the washers? Look at these ones. Do you know what does it mean in Spanish? ¿Saben cómo se llama en español?
Volandas.
Yes, arandelas, sujetadores, right? And in this case, they are flat, right? Good, very good. So you have here a lot of information, right? So, a screwdriver, what's it? In Spanish, what's it?
Destornillador.
Right. A wrench?
Llave inglesa.
Llave inglesa, right. A screws?
Tornillos.
A bolt?
Perno. Tornillo.
Very good. Right. A spanner?
Llave.
An electric drill?
Taladro.
Taladro eléctrico.
Taladro. Very good. Right. Nuts. Tuercas. Right. No olviden que nuts significan también nueces, ¿no? Be careful. Right. Washers.
Arandela.
Arandela. Flores. You say volandas. Right. And we have a lot of different meanings there. Right. What are singular and what are plural? A ver. ¿Cuáles pueden ver ustedes en formato singular y cuáles son palabras plurales? A screwdriver, is it singular or plural?
Singular.
Singular. And we have a, not an, because I don't have here a vowel, right? What about the screws? Singular or plural?
Plural.
And if it's singular, you say solo un tornillo, ¿cómo sería?
An screw.
A screw. Okay, a screw.
A screw.
Good. A spanner, singular or plural?
Singular.
Singular.
Singular. How can you use plural?
Spanners.
Okay, spanners. Right. What about nuts? Singular or plural?
Plural.
Plural. Singular?
Nut.
And nut. Very good. A nut. What about a wrench? Singular or plural?
Singular.
Singular. Si ustedes encuentran un artículo indefinido, de hecho es singular, ¿verdad? Right. A wrench. Plural. Si termina en CH, ¿cuál es el plural?
Wrenches.
Very good. Wrenches. ES. Requiere de una ES, ¿no es cierto? Si encuentra una palabra que termina en OS, H, CH, X, SS, debo aumentar una ES. Right. What about bolt? A bolt. Is it singular or plural?
Singular.
Plural?
Bolts.
Bolts.
An electric drill. So you have here vowel, a, electric, e, here, so an. Plural?
Singular.
Singular.
Yes, it's singular. And how do you change plural? ¿Cómo transforma plural?
Electric drills.
An electric
drills.
Simplemente al final, ¿no? Una palabra nada más debe llevar el plural, que en este caso sería drill, ¿no? Electric. Electric en este caso es un adjetivo, ¿no? Y los adjetivos no tienen plurales tampoco. Entonces, electric drills. Right? Good. What about washers? Is it singular or plural?
Plural.
Plural.
Plural. Washers. Right. And is it singular? Si fuese singular, solo uno.
Washer.
Washers.
Good. A washer. No olviden el artículo si es contable. Right? Porque si no lo usan, es un error. Right? Cuando empleamos incontables, ustedes saben que no tienen plural. Entonces no requieren de artículos. Y siempre llevan el verbo en tercera persona porque son singular. All right? So look at this exercise two. Practice this conversation. What's this in English? It's a screwdriver. What are this? They are washers, right? So we have here singular and plural, right? And you are going to remember that. Van a recordar algo más hoy, all right? That you can use this and that. Look at this. Por favor, nos quedan pocos minutos. Ingresa nuevamente, right? ¿Es muy cansador, chicos? No. You are okay?
Un poco.
Sí, es un poco. Por eso yo les había sugerido descansar unos 10 minutos. Yo creo que lo vamos a hacer desde la próxima semana, ¿right? Porque sí, yo entiendo. Dicen que solo nos concentramos 10 minutos, ¿verdad? En una hora. Y cuando tenemos tanta información para recordar, sí, yo entiendo que es cansador, ¿right? Pero no olviden tener su material disponible, ya sea en formato digital o en físico, all right? So look at this. We are going to work with this. Right? And we work with this and the and those. Okay? So look at this one. And I need that you can see me. So this is my pencil, this, right? This is my cell phone, this. I can touch. Todo lo que puedo tocar and it's near to me is this, singular. This is my pen, right? And this is my cell phone. I don't have here tools. Lamentablemente no tengo herramientas disponibles that we are going to use, right? So, that, right? That is far. That es lejos, del lugar donde yo me encuentro. That's a window. That is, I don't know, a paper or a newspaper, right? So, this and that means for singular. This, something that I can't touch. That, it's far, all right? This, singular, todo lo que puedo tocar. This is my pencil. This is my pen. That is a window. That is my old book, right? That is singular. This, that means plural. Sorry. These are one, two, more than one. These are pens. Those are windows, right? This para plural y those para lejos, plural. All right? This para plural cerca, right? I'm going to show you. Right. This and that you have here, it's for singular, right? Okay, this, when you can touch, cuando puedo tocar algo, this, right? That, cuando el objeto se encuentra lejos, right? So you can say, this is a screwdriver, right? This is a screwdriver. Right? This is a screwdriver. That is a bolt. Singular. All right? This, cuando tengo el objeto muy cerca, o puedo tocarlo. Este es, all right? That is a bolt. Ese es un tornillo. That is that. Cuando no puedo tocar el objeto. All right? These and those for plural. Significa lo mismo, ¿no? Pero en plural. So, I need here an slash. Yes, todo lo que puedo tocar o se encuentra cerca mío. Como es plural, voy a cambiar el verbo. These are, right? These are, ¿cómo transformo screwdriver a plural?
Ya no se escribe la A.
Muy bien, elimino la A y screw
Ya sí,
drivers.
imagínate. Realmente sí.
Muy bien. y aumento una S, ¿no es cierto? These are screwdrivers, plural. Los puedo tocar. Digamos que tengo dos o tres. You can say these are screwdrivers. Or those are, el plural de bolt. ¿Cuál es?
Bolts.
Muy bien.
Bolts.
Bolts. All right. Those, todo aquello que no puedo tocar. Pero es plural, no lo olvide. Right? So, this is a screwdriver. That is a bolt. This, cerca. That, lejos. Y como ustedes pueden ver, tengo el verbo conjugado en tercera persona para singular. This is a screwdriver. That's a bolt. Right? What happened with plural? I use this and those. This para cerca y those para lejos. Right? And I need to change the verb. Requiero cambiar el verbo. Right? Those are screwdrivers. Those are bolts. Right? Por si les interesa la pronunciación. Este this se pronuncia como una IE. This. This is. Right? This. This is a screwdriver. Esta this del plural se pronuncia tal cual una I. ¿Pronuncian ustedes I en español? Es esta. This. Right? This. It's not this. Esta es una E, I. Y esta es una I, como en español. All right? This. These are screwdrivers. Right? So please, could you write an example? Ahora escriban dos ejemplos, por favor. Uno empleando singular y el otro empleando plural. Pueden elegir entre this or entre this and that or this and those. Try to use the vocabulary. Empleen el vocabulario que acabamos de trabajar para que vayan memorizándolo. ¿Ok? 2 minutes. 1 minuto. Right, so what are these? Right, what are these? And the answer?
This.
Son varios. Entonces voy a cambiar ese it por. Voy a cambiarlo por they, ¿no?
They
are, muy bien. Or there, if you use the contracted way. They are as screws, for example. Right? I'm going to go back. Voy a volver a la página para escribir y ustedes se ubiquen mejor. All right? So look at it. Right. So you can say here, what's this? Right? What's this? Estoy usando una forma contractada. Ustedes pueden emplear también la forma, ¿no? What is this? And you can say, this is a screwdriver. O pueden reemplazar este this por it. ¿No es cierto? It is. It is a screwdriver. Su forma formal o contractada. ¿Ok? Tienen esas dos opciones. What's that? What's that? That it's a bolt, or you can say it is a bolt. Right? What about plural? El verbo debe cambiar, ¿verdad? What are these? These are screwdrivers, or you can use they. En su forma formal o contractada. All right? Good. And what about the question? ¿Cómo formulo esta pregunta? What are those? What are those? Se puede responder de ambas formas, ¿no? What are those? Those are balls. Si no quieren usar en la respuesta those, entonces simplemente emplearán el sujeto pronombre que corresponde al plural. Ellos, ¿no? Those, they are balls. That's the idea. Okay? So we are going to practice. ¿Tienen alguna duda al respecto? No? Okay. We're going to practice. Okay. So, what are these? These are screws, or they are screws, right? A spanner. ¿Cómo formulo la pregunta y cuál es la respuesta? A ver.
They are.
Teacher C.
What's this?
Muy bien. What's this? And the answer?
It is a spanner.
Very good. It is a spanner, or this is a spanner. Very good. Excellent. What about nuts?
What are these?
Muy bien. What are these? What are these? And the answer?
These are
nuts. Very good. These are nuts. What about please a wrench? How's the question? How's the question?
What is this?
Muy bien. Excellent. What is this? And the answer?
Is it this an wrench?
Very good. Excellent. This is a wrench. A bolt. What do you say?
What are these?
Mm-hmm. Okay. A bolt. That is singular. A singular.
Pardon. What
yes.
is this?
Very good. What's this? Right? And the answer?
This is a bolt.
This is a bolt. Very good. An electric drill. What's this? Es singular también, ¿verdad? So what's this?
What?
This is an electric.
Muy bien. This is an electric drill, or it's an electric drill. What about the washers?
What are these?
Excellent. What are these? Right? And the answer?
These are washers.
Very good. These are washers. Right? Don't forget, please, that this, that for singular, and this, those for plural. Be careful with the verb, because you are going to use is for singular one, and for plural, you are going to use are. Right? Now, please look at this exercise, please. That's a speaking, checking. Right? Look at, listen, then practice the conversations in pairs, but first listen, okay? Sorry, I'm going to share with you another exercise. So sorry, I'm going to look at 4, 4, 5. Right. Listen, please. Please.
Unit 1. Speaking.
What's in the box?
There are some bolts.
How many?
20.
Good. What's the part number?
P.
PD790. What's that number again? PD790. The list says PD798. They're the wrong bolts.
Listen again.
Unit 1. Speaking.
What's in the box?
There are some bolts.
How many?
20.
Good. What's the part number?
PD790.
What's that number again?
PD790.
The list says PD798. They're the wrong bolts.
Great. So that is a conversation that we are going to practice them, right? So, in fact, today we talk about a lot of information. As vocabulary, you're going to use the alphabet and numbers. And of course, you're going to use the new vocabulary about your occupation, right? What are the new words that you remember today? Of course, you work with on an oil field, onshore, offshore, oil and offshore platform, wells, gas fields, oil fields, and so on, right? And you talk about tools and hardware too, right? A screwdriver, a screws, a spanner, nuts, a wrench, a bolt, an electric drill, washers. So you have here another vocabulary, just the part number and so on, right? So please don't forget to practice and try to write sentences at home using those new words for you, right? And finally, please look at for your textbook to page, please, 8. I'm going to give you some homework, right? Look at, please, exercise 8, reading. Esa es su tarea, por favor, right? Reading, employers. Read about the United Kingdom. Is your country similar or different? Write S, similar, D, different, or I don't know on the right. Similar in my country, right? Employers in the United Kingdom. So please read the information and you are going to write, is it similar, different, or, all right? And you have here, for example, NOC. Some countries have a national oil company, NOC. Do you know what does it mean? Es la abreviación de National Oil Company, all right? National Oil Company. And on the other side, you have there IOC, that it's International Oil Company, that you are going to find in the vocabulary, right? So, reading, please, and project, all right? That's your homework. As people look on the internet, write a few sentences about them and use these cues. But think about Bolivia, all right? Think about Bolivia. Company name in Bolivia, information about the company, and you have here useful words, big or small, international oil company, or that's a national one, right? I prefer that you talk about Bolivia if you want to an international one, so do it, right? Foreign or local, foreign means extranjero, and operating company or service company. So those are your homework, right? Please look at that's all for the homework, right? Because the next class we are going to finish and we are going to start with our new lesson, right? Quiero hacerles una recomendación. Chicos, chicas, all right? So, es importante que ustedes participen y tengan el material. Miren, es realmente una pérdida de tiempo yo recorrer toda una fila mencionando sus nombres sin ningún tipo de respuesta, ¿no? Perdemos uno, dos, tres minutos y es hasta cansador, ¿no es cierto? Entonces, si ustedes no tienen el material, el día de la clase, que es una sola clase, ¿right? Por favor, deben tener todo listo para poder participar. Yo entiendo que muchos de ustedes no tengan sus micrófonos disponibles, pero pueden usar el chat. Como les comentaba, si ustedes a la segunda llamada, tercera llamada no responden, yo voy a proceder a eliminar, porque tengo un grupo en este momento de 32 personas. Pero ¿cuántos participan? Yo tengo la lista, el registro en este momento y puedo mencionar los nombres. Los que han escrito al chat, los que participan de forma permanente y los demás, simplemente yo tengo la impresión de que prenden su monitor, su pantalla y abandonan la clase. Esa es la impresión que yo tengo si ustedes no responden. Como les digo, es una pérdida de tiempo y es hasta cansador para ustedes y para mi persona también, ¿no es cierto? Entonces, para la próxima clase, intenten participar, tengan el material. Si tienen alguna dificultad para ingresar o tienen una emergencia, no pueden tomar la clase, pueden solicitar permiso, porque a mí no me sirve de nada, chicos, que ustedes estén viendo el celular o prenden el celular y realmente no pueden trabajar, ¿no? Entonces, yo no puedo hacerme responsable de ello, right? If you participate, I know that you are going to learn and you are going to know how the process. Instead of that, I can do anything. No puedo hacer nada, right? So, y no olviden que aprender el idioma es un todo, ¿no? Si yo no comprendo esta primera unidad, si no la recuerdo de forma correcta, entonces es muy difícil que yo pueda continuar de forma satisfactoria. En cuanto se refiere a las palabras específicas, las que estamos aprendiendo, sí, yo les sugiero que todas aquellas con las cuales tengan dificultad puedan escribir oraciones, ¿no? Entonces, solicito que ustedes participen, ¿right? El enlace es recurrente. Yo sé que es complicado usar Meet, Zoom, porque cada 40 minutos perdemos la señal, ¿no? Sin embargo, Zoom tiene un mejor sonido y tiene muchas más opciones para que ustedes puedan interactuar entre ustedes, ¿right? Meet me parece bastante pasivo. Sin embargo, tenemos la ventaja de que el tiempo es ilimitado, ¿no? Pero el sonido tampoco es muy bueno. Entonces, en el caso de que requeramos, para que ustedes tampoco se cansen tanto al ingresar, salir, entonces vamos también a usar Meet, ¿right? No olviden que la tolerancia para ingresar, como habíamos acordado con ustedes, es 10 minutos. La primera clase, la segunda, acordamos muchas cosas, ¿no? Espero lo tomen en cuenta, ¿right? Si tienen alguna dificultad, por favor, escriban, ¿right? No escriban al WhatsApp privado porque yo no respondo, chicos, y tengo el teléfono apagado. Tampoco escucho las llamadas y no respondo a las llamadas. Lamentablemente hubo una confusión en otra carrera y han publicado mi número de teléfono con un paralelo equivocado. Entonces, imagínense, tengo cientos de personas que o de estudiantes que me escriben y que yo no conozco los nombres, entonces tampoco sé a qué grupo se refieren. No puedo hacerlo. Entonces, si ustedes escriben al grupo solicitando información o solicitando permiso, yo hago todo lo posible para responder en cuanto esté disponible, ¿right? Sé que muchos de ustedes tuvieron problemas al ingresar a la plataforma. Es importante que lo hagan porque si no, ¿cómo repasan y estudian si tienen el material allá, verdad? Entonces, deben ingresar a plataforma, revisar todo el material que ustedes tienen, practicar, and so on, ¿right? Muchos de ustedes, como sé, Ramiro Uluri, creo, es el único de ustedes que solicitó extensión del tiempo para poder ingresar y que aún no ha enviado tampoco su correo. Si ustedes no pueden navegar en la cuenta institucional, entonces ustedes no tienen otra alternativa, deben usar la cuenta personal. Entonces, Ramiro, si estás en línea, debes enviar lo más antes posible tu correo, ¿right? El que vas a usar. ¿Alguna consulta, chicos?